Hi, Krita is a free and open source painting program. I'm using Krita 4 version. This tutorial is supposed to be a tutorial for beginners. When you open Krita for a first time, for a main language it may use either English or your native language. If you, for some reason, want to change the language of Krita, you can do it in Settings menu. Settings, switch application language. If you change the language, you need to restart Krita to see the changes. For my experience, it's better to use English as main Krita language because it's easier to find any additional information about tools, features and tutorials. Okay, let's create a new document. File, New. I usually choose Custom Document and these are dimensions. If I want to print my document later, I set resolution to 300 and I choose SMYK model here. But if I'm not gonna print it, I set model to RGB and set resolution to 72. It's enough. Now open Content tab. What I do here, I prefer to have two layers at the start, and one of them is the background layer. I use gray color at the start. You can click on it and change the color as you want. And the second layer is transparent. Okay, now I lock the background layer in order to prevent it from me drawing on it. Considering the interface, you can move all these small panels like in any other painting software. Also, you can save your workspace or load any standard workspace right here. For instance, I saved my workspace and if I need to use animation, I could load workspace for it here. And after I've done with that, I can go back to my workspace and load it again. About all these panels, you can find them here in the Settings menu, Settings Dockers, and here you can tick any docker that you want. I use Advanced Color Selector, which is the color wheel. You can click on this button on the top left corner, and here you change the color model. I also use Color Slider Docker, Brush Presets, list of brushes right here, Layers, Overview. In many other programs, this panel is called Navigator. Basically, it's a small version of your canvas. Palette Docker, which contains color swatches. You can add and save colors that you like in order to create your own palettes. And here we have Toolbox, which is all the tools right here. And tool options. This docker is extremely important, because here you can adjust all the settings of all Krita tools. For instance, I can pick bucket tool, choose color and fill the area. But on the tool options I can adjust all its options and also I can tick use pattern and now I can fill the area with pattern, not the color. I choose the pattern here. Okay, now I'll tell a few words about tools, but only a few because I can't cover every single tool and all its options. But actually, you can learn all about it on your own on Krita website. People who created this documentation are amazing because here you have short and informative description of every single tool with all the shortcuts. And honestly, it's better than any YouTube video about them. By the way, you can adjust all the shortcuts in the menu. Settings, Config Krita, Keyboard Shortcuts. Going back on tools, besides drawing and selecting tools, Krita allows you to use vector tools. You can use them on vector layer. You can create it right here. If you don't need using vector, you can work on a paint layer. Okay, now let's pick our main tool, which is the brush tool. Shortcut for it is B on your keyboard. And you can control the size of your brush either here on the toolbar or in the brush settings here. You can find all the brush settings right here. Also, to control the brush size, you can use the shortcuts, like holding shift button and dragging your mouse to the right or to the left. I personally prefer to use square brackets on my keyboard to control brush size. And here I set these two fields to opacity and flow. If you press E button on your keyboard or this button on the toolbar, you activate eraser mode for the brush you are using at the moment. Press E again and you can go back to the brush mode. When you draw, sometimes you need to make straight lines, and instead of switching to the line tool, press and hold V on your keyboard. If you hold Shift, you can control the angle. If you need to pick a color from your canvas, you can press and hold Ctrl, and you activate the Color Picker tool. You can activate Pen tool holding spacebar button on your keyboard. You can rotate your canvas with 4 and 6 button. And 5 resets the rotation. Here are selection tools, and you can select the area and either grab a transform tool or press Ctrl+T, and you can transform this area. Don't forget to open Tool Options Docker to adjust the settings of transform tool. And my favorite tool is Assistant tool. It's a lifesaver when it comes to drawing in perspective. I choose here vanishing point, select brush tool and tick snap to assistant, and I can draw in perspective. I also use parallel ruler and sometimes perspective grid. If you right-click on the canvas in Krita, you will get a pop-up palette. It contains brush presets and some other settings. I've talked about it when I made a video about Krita 4 release. You can change the amount of brushes on this palette in the menu Settings, Config Krita, General, and here you can change it. But for some reason, some people find this pop-up palette irritating. And if you're one of them, you can turn it off in this Settings menu. Settings, Config Krita, Canvas and Settings. Also, you may want to add to your toolbar a few new buttons. Let's add Undo and Redo buttons. We'll go to Settings menu, Config Toolbars, choose Brushes and Stuff toolbar, and here we search what we want to add. And here we have it. Okay, that's it for today. I really hope that this video was helpful. If you liked it, please share it in your social media. It can help the channel to grow. Thanks for watching. Oh, I also wanted to mention that one of my favorite Krita tutorials are ones made by Age of Asparagus. I used to learn Krita by them when I opened it for the first time, and I admire all the work he has done. Now his tutorials is a bit out of date because he used Krita 2.9 version, but it's still great. I'll leave the link in the description. Maybe you can find it helpful too. And of course, don't forget to watch David Rivoire's tutorials. They are extremely helpful. Bye, thanks for staying with me.